Svelte is a great framework. It uses its compiler to augment vanilla JS syntax with reactivity and state. But that compiler magic is also a problem. Why? We'll dive into that in a second. Because to solve that problem, the Svelte team is leaning into the magic, not shying away from it, with a new feature coming in Svelte 5 called runes. Runes use the function syntax to provide more expressive, more explicit, reactive magic. Now, what are runes? Are they making Svelte more magical, or is Svelte becoming un-svelte-like? What does all this mean for the future of Svelte? We'll look into all that and more. To understand, we first need to take a look at the problem that runes are trying to solve. Today, Svelte uses let equals the export keyword and the dollar colon label to manage state. But that poses a problem. It creates a mental shortcut or heuristic where you expect the syntax to work in a certain way. As long as you stay within the context where it works, everything is fine. But that context is limited. The syntax doesn't work the same way, for example, in JavaScript files. When you're outside of the context, the mental shortcut fails, and that can cause confusion. It can also make refactoring more complicated. So for example, if we wrap the reactive let of a Svelte component into a function, that no longer works as expected. So what is the solution? Well, first let's look at how Svelte implements reactivity. And a good way of understanding that is by contrasting it with how React works. React keeps a copy of the component tree in memory. It's what's known as the virtual DOM. When the state changes, React compares the nodes and then re-renders any nodes that are affected by the change. It's simple to understand, but it's also a fairly brute force approach. Svelte uses the compiler to analyze the code. It detects which variables express state. It determines the dependency graph that links these variables. I've explained how that works in another video. But when a variable changes somewhere, the application knows exactly which part of the interface to change. And that's what we mean by fine-grained reactivity. The compiler connects the different bits that change. But this compiler-based approach has a problem. You can only express reactivity if you send the right signals to the compiler. For example, in the following code, the compiler can only see the dependency on the width state variable when it analyzes the code at the colon dollar label. With complex state, the compiler's implicit magic becomes a constraint instead of a strength. Overloading let and equals is limited to the top level of Svelte components. So if you need to encapsulate your state's logic in a JavaScript file, you can't. And if you want to put it all into a function, you can't. To solve this problem, Svelte has announced runes, which will be a part of Svelte 5 when that comes out. Now, what are runes? The blog post states that runes are symbols that influence the Svelte compiler to achieve the same effect that the previous syntax overloads did. Runes are a way of explicitly telling the compiler what you want. Runes allow you to invoke Svelte's compiler magic, and I think that's why they're called runes, although they do also remind me of compile time C++ macros. Under the hood, runes inform the compiler to set up reactivity using something called signals. What are signals and how do they work? Well, they're a paradigm that is now being used in a lot of front-end frameworks, the one major notable exception being, of course, React. As I mentioned, the compiler sets up a dependency graph between state variables. Signals is kind of a runtime version of that dependency graph. Signals connect the state and the interface, not just when the code is compiled, but also when it is run. So let's start with a simple example. To define state, we use the $state rune. So instead of let count equals zero, we can now write let count equals $state 0. This makes it a lot clearer that the variable actually holds state. It tells the compiler explicitly this is intended to be a variable that holds state. And using that explicit symbol instead of overloading vanilla JS syntax allows us to use this code more widely within a shared library, for example, or in a function, not just at the top level of the component. And in the same way, and for the same reason, the export let syntax that was currently being used to declare props will be replaced by the $props syntax, where we then write const width equals $props. Now, as we saw in the multiply by height example, Svelte's reactivity and dependency tracking is currently compile time only. So this code here doesn't work because the compiler only sees the dependency on width, not on height. Runes allow runtime reactivity, where the dependencies are determined when the expression is evaluated. To declare the dependencies, we use the $derived rune. Here with this code, area will actually also update when the height state variable changes. Finally, to execute code when there are any changes, we'll be using the $effect rune, which will trigger when any state variable it is dependent on changes. Now, what does this mean in practice for Svelte? Is it a step back or is it a step forwards? Well, we'll have to see in practice. This is coming in Svelte 5, which as of recording has no release date. For now, we only have a playground to mess around with. I've provided a link to that in the description. The new syntax makes much of the classic Svelte syntax obsolete. The $:: syntax, the top level let and export, will no longer be useful and will actually be phased out. I liked the idea of using the compiler to define the state implicitly, but I was afraid of the confusion that it might cause, and it looks like the Svelte team has come to pretty much the same conclusion. Although looking through the Svelte Discord channel, not everyone in the community agrees with the change. I think it's a step in the right direction. It's a sign of the framework's maturity. It brings Svelte closer to being a more widely accepted solution. It enables more complex applications. I'm just not sure how much the Svelte community will be on board. My bottom line is that by allowing you to trigger the magic explicitly, Svelte is giving you greater powers and, of course, great responsibilities. Although you could reasonably complain that runes make Svelte less magical. What do you think of the change? Let me know in the comments, and in any case, I'll see you in the next video.